Iwuanyanwu had to come down and said to him, please, in case I don't make it, I don't take care of my family. And my father couldn't make it. He played that active role doing very well. And then I just left school, I was about 18. After the burial, he now said to my mother, because she has to go and join her sister. I came to London, I paid my school fees for 4 years. And since then, it has been stood by us. Iwuanyanwu is a very wonderful, intelligent, very hardworking, and with somebody to reckon with. We were shocked when we lost Auntie Idora. May her soul rest in peace. Mm-hmm. And we were all praying for him to get married. And when he got married to Frances, Frances, who I'm in love with, she's a young lady, but she has a matured mind. She's intelligent and beautiful, but it was very good. Until today, all of us were coming down with Frances. And I thank God, I did go to God that at the end of the day, I got married to somebody. He loves the Lord and take care of him. Happy birthday, Ahej Agamba of Ujimu, Chief Engineer Emmanuel Iwuanyanwu, our own. We are very proud of you. And God will keep your life for us. God bless you.
I am indeed very grateful and thankful to God Almighty, today in particular. I'm happy to congratulate Chief Dr. Engineer Emmanuel Chukwuemeka Iwuanyanwu Ahej Agamba Ndi Igbo on this special occasion of his 80th birthday. Apart from his great accomplishments in different fields of human endeavor, he stands out in his simplicity, nurtured in the fear of God. He is a man who believes in pragmatic approach to problems. He often remarks, dwell in the solution and not the problem. I thank God today and therefore wish him a very happy birthday, greater health, greater vision, and urge him not to relent as he continues to reinvent himself and pioneer the affairs of men. On behalf of my family, the entire Awurum family, thank God Almighty for today. I congratulate you, sir, and wish you Godspeed in all you do. Thank you. May you continue to enjoy good health. May God continuously walk and walk with you.
Chief Iwuanyanwu, my chairman, is a very, very disciplined person. That he is the group chairman controlling all this fleet of businesses did not make him to look at the norms of the company. In those days, Chief would come to the office before any person and leave after every other person. He's a workaholic. I must tell you, he's a workaholic. He has a brain as sharp as razor. And you really, really have to be on your toes to work with him. He's a very disciplined person. And I must tell you, one thing that is particular about him is he is an honest person and demands that anybody he is dealing with must be honest. If you make a mistake and you tell him, sir, I made this mistake, he will admonish you, he will correct you, but he would not punish you for a mistake you made indeliberately, except if he finds out that you had other intentions in that. So he's a man who I can say is very, very disciplined. And above all this, his status in the society notwithstanding, he's a very humble person. I can refer to him as somebody who is humble in affluence. And in terms of work, he demands that you are hardworking. He demands that you are straightforward, upright, and he rewards honesty and hard work. In those days, he would go and buy about 12, a dozen of 504 vehicles, and he would share it to his staff. He would buy houses, and he would give to his staff. Empty lands, he would give. I'm a beneficiary. Where I live, he gave to me. And not just that. He can give you a property as a bonus for hard work, for achievement or work. He can give you a vehicle. And it's not somebody who sees you that, oh, because you are working for him, you should not grow. No. He enjoys seeing people under him grow. And just not just growing, he's also passionate about your family. If you have any misfortune, he will come there personally. He asks you about your family. He takes interest in how your family is developing, your children, your wife, your brothers, your sister. So I can see that he's a man who wants people who are coming after him to grow up and become something in life. I wish him, God has blessed him. All that we are praying for him is that God should keep him longer for us, because we are still drinking from his large heart, his meek of human kindness. We are still learning, tapping from his knowledge. He's a colossus in business. He's a colossus in politics. He has left partisanship, but we still go and consult him to teach us things we should do in politics. So what I pray God to give him is good life, long life, and above all, good health, so that in the long life, he will enjoy it in good health. And you can see that looking at him, he does not look 80, because he has the blessings of God going with him. And he's somebody who believes in the implicit confidence. He has implicit confidence in the power of God. As you see him, he goes to church every Sunday. During Ash Wednesday, he attends all the weekly meetings. Whatever thing he's doing, he places God first. He built a church in my village, not just building, and furnished it. St. Matthew's Cathedral, as it is standing now, that is the gift. Chief says all that he needs to do, all that is important to him, is to see that he completes this house of God and donates it to God, and that he accomplished.
Well, how will I describe him? I personally call him my daddy. He's an elder statesman. And whether you are in ABGA, whether you are in APC, whether you are in PDP, or whatever party, he treats us as one. And I remember at times he says, hey, Apokwa me hen ku embasra anokwam party ke. Anyi un chango first wo, anyi unne unye kedro o anyi unye. Imo State or a new one in Nigeria. And that should guide us in all we are doing. And we're all comfortable, we're very, very comfortable, because it's fair. You know, that you go to his house, it's non-political. You see APC people there, coming to even take advice, seek advice on a matter that's supposed to be strictly APC. You see PDP person people coming to meet him, seek advice on the internal, very internal party. You see a MAPCA person or group that also come there. Maybe while you are waiting, you see APCA person in one corner, APCA PDP person in one corner. Because we all trust, yes, if you go, he will give advice how to solve your problem in the APC. The PDP man who has our group, who has come to him, He gives them advice how to solve their problem in PDP. The APCA person, you give them some. We are very, very comfortable with him. He is a father. I am from Ikedu. I tell you one typical thing. We were having problem, but I'm the political leader of APC in Ikedu. We were having problem deciding on whom we will take as our House of Assembly flag bearer. I went to him. I said, Daddy, Mr. A, Mr. B, they are on our neck. They want to tear this thing. And he gave me very useful advice that I've never thought of. That now made me to look for bringing other options. And the moment I was going for a party meeting for 3 o'clock, I was waiting by 1 o'clock. By 2 o'clock, he had given me advice. I was so excited. And when I went into this leadership meeting in our place, these two people that were even, well, they kept talking to us.